Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. So there are many different types of intelligence in the world, right? I mean, think about it. If you're good with mechanics, you might be spatially intelligent. Or if you're good with other people, you might be intrapersonally intelligent. Now, this is unfortunate because today, I'm not intelligent in the area we're studying. We're going to look at the components of beatboxing, and then we're going to use a Phantom to record some slow motion beatboxing, which is insane. And then we're going to use that data to study the physics of what the mouth is actually doing to produce the sound that we know as beatboxing. Now, I'm not intelligent enough to do this on my own, so we're going to have to go meet somebody that's far more intelligent than I am. I know this might not make sense to you, but this is Flula.
Hello, guys.
Boom! Okay, so Flula is a German guy that, well, you do music. That's what you do.
Yeah. I like to make beatboxes and loops of techno, hip-hop, things like that.
Yeah, so here's the deal. I really like his channel because it's fun, and he does music, and I don't really understand it. So you've agreed to give me a lesson in beatboxing?
Absolutely. So this is a layer looping pedal, and I can create many loops and a layer on the tops.
Okay.
But if I like, I can bring these to this machine, and then I have four different tracks to use.
What?
Yeah, so shall I show you?
Yeah, please.
Okay, so here is a beat.
Yeah.
And now let us bring it inside here. Okay, so now it's in here, it's living inside.
Yeah.
Now let us add something, right? Let's do it. Boom. Watch out, basses. Right? And now maybe some sing songs, yeah? Right?
Okay. I get it.
For me, you know, many beatboxers have different things. For me, three things.
Okay.
There's a bass.
Okay.
Like that.
Yeah.
And then you have like the snare, like with the sticks, the snare drum.
Like snare drum.
Snare. Yeah, snare. So, and I like, for me, I like, like that. Other people may go, shh,
you know. That's your snare drum?
That's my snare.
Okay. Yeah. All right, go ahead.
So, and then of course, the hi-hats, you know.
Got it.
Yeah, so put together.
Yep. Yeah. Clearly there's skill here, and so here's what we're going to do. I'm making a trade with Flula. I told him if he would teach me how to beatbox, I would create a slow motion video of him beatboxing. So that's what we're going to do. So I've got the Miro here, and what we're going to do is we're going to like look at your lips. Are you cool with that?
Let's do it.
Don't even think about it. Let's just analyze it. Okay, check it out. We've got Flula up here who's about to drop the bass, and above me I have what's called a spectrogram. I've got time in the x-axis, and I have frequency in the y-axis. So watch this. Check it out. Pretty cool colors. Now, the brighter the colors, that means the louder the frequency is at that particular point in time. Now, it looks like we have these dark vertical bars. It's like we have frequency within frequency, and that's exactly what we have, and this is very important. It's called timbre. Let's play the C2 note on a piano. Now, the same note using a triangle wave. You'll notice the fundamental frequencies determine the note, and they're the same, but the overtones are different. These overtones are how our brains recognize different instruments. It's known as the timbre, or the color of the sound. So think about the texture of Flula's bass drop. It's actually two different functions working together. The first one is a normal tone coming from his vocal cords. It's just a normal looking sound wave. But the second thing is coming from his lips. When his lips slam shut, his mouth builds pressure back up until it gets high enough to blow that lip out again. The resonant frequency of this is determined by the pressure in his mouth, the flow rate of the air, and how tight he's pushing his lips together. Both of these functions are combined to create a unique sound signature. So if our slow-mo observations are correct, we should be able to see all these things in the spectrogram, right? Yep, check it out. You can plainly see that the fundamental frequency from his vocal cords is down here, and you can see that the lip is slamming shut about every 25 milliseconds and stopping that airflow. You can then see that the sound is loudest immediately after the pressure in his mouth gets high enough to pop that lip open, and if you look really, really close, you can even see spots where his lip is slamming back shut. So there you have it. Beatboxers are not just dudes with good rhythm. They're actually biomechanical synthesizers that specialize in the domination of not just the time domain, but also the frequency domain. Okay, I hope you earned your subscription today because you learned something, but more importantly, I'd love for you to check out Flula and subscribe to him. He has never heard of me. I called him because we were in the same city and he agreed to do this. And he's got a smaller channel, but I think it's very, very clever. And I think he deserves a shot. I'm gonna leave some links over here. He's done something called auto tunes, where he drives in a car and he plays an entire song by himself in one take. It's extremely clever and I'm very impressed. So go check that out. Those are probably my favorite. And I'll show you what he did with the slow motion footage, which is pretty funny in itself. Anyway, I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one. Can you do me an outro and I'll use it at the end of the video?
Yes, of course.
Thank you very much, Flula.
Of course.